And here is what I think is a kind of an interesting question, or at least approach to the questions. Here are the five equations that we will be using. And by the way, normally I say that we should I normally say that we should sort of memorize these, but you know what? I'm going to make these five equations available for the exam, along with sort of a lot of the other equations. Now, you will notice that each one is set up to include four of these variables. And some people were saying, well, what's VF and VI? Well, VF is the final velocity, VI is the initial velocity, and it's the same as V2 and V1. Some of them have variables that are each one has a variable that is not included in the equation. And so basically what you're doing is you're going through your equation, you're looking for your given and required variables. And then you're going to pick one of these equations basically to help you solve the problem. Now, there are a few tricky things when they ask you these questions. So, a motorcyclist is traveling at 15 meters per second forward. Good, there's VI or V1 and applies the brakes. The motorcycle slows down at 5 meters per second squared backwards. And so, you know, you've got to take into account positive and negative. So there's A. So we have V1 and we have A. Determine the motorcycle's braking distance. And so they're secretly telling you VF, the final velocity here. And they're saying that it is zero because that's the braking distance. And then the last variable that's involved is distance. This is what we are required to find. And so you need to decode your way through the equation. And then look up here and say, well, we were given VI and we were given VF sort of sneakily. Were we given T in this one? No, we were not given T. So VI, VF, we were given A and D is involved. So we want VI, VF, A, and D. And so it looks like we are using equation four. And so, you know, you would drag equation four up here. And hopefully it would all work. Anyway, that's how this question works. I hope it works. When you're done, actually answer these. Question number five, you wind up with two equations and two unknowns. You need to work it out that way. That is a tough one. We'll probably take.